Good morning. I'm getting ready for work. Today is St. Patrick's Day. I'm not certain whether I'm going to do any green on my face or not. We'll see. We'll see how I feel once I get to that point. The first thing I'm going to do is put some moisturizer on. I just wiped my face off. I'm going to use the By Terry primer because it is moisturizing. Or Hyaluronic. It is the By Terry Hyaluronic Hydra-primer. And that's going to go on first. And then I'm going to put on my eye cream. This is one that we sell at the Medi Spa. There we go. Now I'm going to put on an eyeshadow primer. I'm going to put on a lip treatment first. I'm going to use the Grande Lip. It immediately brings color to my lips. I used this yesterday as my eyeshadow primer. It worked out pretty good. It's the It Cosmetic CC Eye. So I can use up some products. Oh, and I wanted to show you this. I would say this is officially used up. And I used my new spatula. To get it out. So, I would say that was officially empty, wouldn't you? And it was the Too Faced Born This Way in Warm Nude. So that's officially empty. So I've officially emptied one, and I won't feel so silly when I replace it. When I buy another foundation. And the one I'm going to use today, I think, is on its last few pumps. I didn't get enough the first time. I want a nice, smooth, even canvas for my look today. So I have a St. Patrick's Day shirt that I wear every year that I bet I've had it 15 years at least. I bought it at the Lucky Brand store. I'm going to go get it. Actually, it's in the washing machine now. I washed it because it's been in the storage box, which is like, you know, it's got a plastic lid and all, but I'm highly allergic to dust mites. So I'm going to go put that in the dryer, and I'll be right back. All right. Shirt's in the dryer. Let's begin the look. I'm going to pull out my Morphe Icy Fantasy Palette, and there are some greens in this. I'm not going to make green the major color, though. I'm going to use, we'll do purple, pinks, and greens. How about that? My crease color is Hush. So I'm not watching anything on TV. Oh, actually, I started a movie last night, but I didn't finish it. I cut off the light and read. I wanted to get back to my story, Educated by Tara Westover. I'm buffing that out real good because I only want that to be a shadow. Then I'm going to take the color, I didn't put on my glasses before I came in here, Deliver Shiver. It's a gray purpley, and I'm swirling that in the outer corner. So this hair, let's see, what day are we on? I did this on Saturday, and it was on top of my head all night. But this is what I have left so far of that, from that hair tutorial I did for you. This is the new Essie polish. It's the quick dry Essies that have kind of a skinny tall bottle. IRL, I don't know what IRL stands for. What does IRL stand for? I don't know. I can't find it. When I find out, I'll put edit it right. I'll put it right there when I'm editing. Okay. There's that purpley gray out there. Now I am going to use a green. I'm really scared to use green. I think I'm only going to use green as the accent color. I'm going to take a flat concealer brush and I'm going to put the color Imagine on my lid. It's a fleshy, peachy, metallic, or shiny. I don't know what you call that. Shiny. I think I'm going to take it on into the teared up. And then I'm going to take the one that's next to it. It's called Rosy Haze. I'm going to put that right. Just inside that, peeking out from underneath the gray purpley one. What was it? Deliver Shiver. See if I can deepen. I'm going to deepen up the Deliver Shiver with Arctic Abyss. There we go. And for my pop of green, I'm going to take a pencil brush and take some of these greens here. There's greens here in the center. I'm going to take one of these and put it in this, on the bottom lash line as an accent color. Which color am I using? I'm using Dazed. And I'm going to take, I have a green liner pen from Stila. Let's look at that. Let's give that a go. I'm keeping this up close to the lash line. Got a little carry away on the other side. I'm going to do a purplish liner on the top. I think I'm going to use the Charlotte Tilbury Amethyst. And then I'm going to take another pencil brush and smudge that. It moves pretty easy. This one is called Color Chameleon Amethyst Aphrodisiac. It's one of these. And I'm smudging that in the top lash line. And then I'm taking a pencil brush and dragging it out. Then I'm gonna take my Tom Ford black pencil and put that on my tight line to make my lashes look thick. So I have my eyebrows on. Now I'm gonna put on my foundation. I'm gonna use the La Mer in Sand. We're down to the bottom of dregs of this one too. So I'll be able to say I finished two bottles. Take one down, pass it around. And this is my Beakey sponge. I'm going to need my little spatula for this. Or I can use it off the end of this. Here we go. I hate getting things dirty because then they get on my desk. I'll show you how it works. It fits right down in there. There we go. Now I have too much. I'll wipe some back off on there. All right, let's see if we have good coverage. Pretty good. I'm gonna have to get some concealer to get on the point of this. Now I'm gonna put, I don't know why I skipped to that step. I've misplaced my Grande, oh, there it is. Let's put the Grande lash on Some of you gave me recommendations for mascaras that have conditioning serums in them. Comment here if you use one of those mascaras that's supposed to improve the condition of your eyelashes. See, somebody, I can't remember, was it Rimmel? Somebody said had one. Was that you, Marsha, that said that? Because this is only a tiny little sample size. And I may want to continue with the conditioning mascara practice after this runs out. All right, there's one coat of mascara. I pulled out a really old pair of lashes today. They look pretty. I don't even know that those go together. I don't think I'm gonna wear those. Those look ratchet. Yeah, I'm not wearing those. They look grungy. I may not wear lashes at all. My eyelashes are looking pretty good with just the mascara. I'm gonna go back and put the colors on that I put on previously. That's the Imagine, and this is the Rosy Haze, the Arctic Abyss. I'm going to take, I don't know what I did with my pencil brush that I was using, the Green Wet. This one is called Cosmic Kohl. This one is not just shiny, it's glittery. I'm gonna put some white colors underneath my brow bone. This one is called White Out. This will be the first year that I haven't used my Makeup Forever 8E pencil. That was my favorite green pencil for years. Let's try this one. Actually, let's try Snow Glow. Now for another layer of mascara. I'm going to use one that's not conditioning over the top of the conditioning one. This one is the Too Faced Better Than Sex. And I'm going to divide my lashes out some. And when those little dots dry, I'm going to sweep the mascara, dried mascara away, the places where it bumped. And now I'm just diffusing along the line of that eyeshadow. There we go. Let's do an under eye concealer. I'm going to use the Maybelline Instant Age Rewind. And I'm going to use my F64 brush. I'm going to use my Chanel Tan de Soleil, Soleil Tan de Chanel. And I'm going to use my Here it is, my Mally brush. I've looked for this for y'all. I think QVC has this brush. I think you have to buy it with something else though. I think Ruth knows. Ruth, comment here. Where do you get this Mally brush? All right. So there's the cream contour. Now I'm gonna go in, or the cream bronzer, and now I'm gonna go in with a little bit of contour. And I'm gonna use my Sigma Soft Angle Contour F23. I know, it looks like that's what it was made for, doesn't it? There's that. And I'm using the Lorac Pro Contour Kit. Looks like this. And I'm using the darkest one. I know, I did that too fast. I'm using the darkest one. It's called Deep Contour. And what's left on my brush, I'm going to tap these other places. I pulled out an old palette. Somebody said they like seeing me use my stuff and not pulling out new every time. This is by Real Her. It's a blush kit. Be Fearless, Be Limitless. Real Her. I'm just going to use some of it. I'm going to start off with the Unstoppable, the bronzier looking one. I'm using a Duo Fiber Powder Blush F15. Then I'm going to use the one in the middle. It's called Limitless. Then I'm going to use Fearless, which has some gold in it. It's sheeny. Like that. I'm going to take some of the Jouer. Run it across my nose. And where's my, this is my highlight brush. Not my highlight brush, my concealer brush. It may still have some Maybelline Instant Age Rewind on it. Then I'm gonna use the fluffy brush to powder under my eyes. I'm gonna use the Laura Mercier translucent powder. I used Caribbean C in the outside corner waterline. I didn't bring it all the way in because I didn't want to close up my eyes. This is Caribbean C. It's another Mally product. So I used the Mally eye pencil and the Mally brush. I had an opportunity to take a look at my eyes in another mirror, and I decided that I'm going to add a pop of purple to the top. And I'm going to use this really bright one called Dreamer. I don't know if that added anything or took away. And then I'm going to take Spellbinding and add it. It's a frosty purple. Some brow gel. This is the Benefit 24-hour brow setter that I use often. I was watching Stephanie Lang. She likes her brows to stand up too. Also, she used Too Faced Glitter Glue to make her brows stand up. They were almost like they were laminated brows. When I mention other videos, do y'all want the link for that so you can go look at it too, or do you not care? Comment here. If you care, let me know and I'll try to start leaving the links for the videos that I'm referring to. Now I'm leaving holes in my brows. I have to go back and touch up the holes. There's not enough blush. There we go. Now for lips. This is the Kim KW by Charlotte Tilbury. It's got a lot of pigment in it. And then I'm going to take the Charlotte Tilbury, the lip cheat in Pillow Talk, the medium one, not the original. Then I'm going to use I've enjoyed using the Becca Hydra Mist, what is it called? Hydra Mist Set and Refresh Powder. I've enjoyed it. if you want to be a little more purposeful in your, or specific in your powder placement, this is a nice brush. It's a Spotlight Duster from Sigma. It's the F37. And you can be more specific in your powder placement. It's very blurring, isn't it? I'm going to work on my hair and put on my outfit, my St. Patrick's Day outfit, and I'll be right back to show you that before I leave for work. Thanks for watching this part, and stay tuned for the next part. Don't click out. So I'm dressed pretty casual today. This is a super old t-shirt from Lucky. I got it at the outlet store probably, I don't know, maybe 18. I think the boys were really little. Probably 18 years ago, between 15 and 18 years ago. And I only wear it once a year on St. Patrick's Day. This is just a pink t-shirt because I'm always cold. I needed more than one layer. This is a super old belt. Came from either Gap or Old Navy. Probably 15 or 18 years old too. Old Michael Kors watch, probably 6 years old. American Eagle jeans. They're too big, that's why I have the belt on. I probably had these for 4 years. I have on my Adidas sneakers because they match my jeans. It's a real casual day. The doctor won't be in the office today. We'll just be there mostly doing paperwork and answering the phones. So that's why I can get by with that today. Here's the fragrance I was telling y'all about. The Tokyo Milk number 14 Waltz. And the notes are linden. Honeyed rose, wisteria petals, and white musk. Smells like Easter flowers. Except for, that would include lilies, right? And lilies stink. So there's that. There's my look of the day. And I'm going to get a few, I'm going to get my stuff together, and I'll meet you in the car, and we'll drive over to the mini spa. Y'all have a, that's my look of the day. I'm going to go get my stuff together, and I'll meet you in the car. Don't click out. Stay around for that part.